In this video, we're going to create a quick loading screen so that you can have this set up when you are transitioning between scenes if you have long load times. I'm going to be building in an artificial delay just so we can actually see what this looks like, but you won't want that if your game has long enough load times. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to go into my loading screen scene folder, and I'm going to create a scene. We're going to call this our loading screen. We want to change this type to a canvas layer. We're going to have a few things beneath this. We're going to have a color rect. We are going to have a label. We're going to have a sprite 2D that is going to have an animation player. We're going to have an icon be rotating in the bottom right of our screen. And then we are going to have a timer. So let's go into our loading screen. And just to make sure that we're on the top layer, just set the layer to 100. And the process mode needs to be on always. Our color rect is going to be a black color. You can make this what you'd like. I'm going to have it be black. And we want it to be a full rect. We want it to take up the entirety of the screen. The label is going to be here. We're going to do this center horizontal. For right now, I'm going to mark this as uppercase and just type in the words loading here. And horizontal alignment can be on the center. For our sprite, which is going to be the Godot icon here, I'm just going to make it a little bit smaller and put them in the bottom right over here. And in our animation player, we're going to create an animation, just call it rotate. It's going to default, it's going to loop, and I'm going to have this do over the course of 2.4 seconds. And at the first, at zero, we're going to go back to our sprite, we're going to key in the frame. And then we're going to go to our transform and key in the rotation. So then we go to 0.6. We're going to set the rotation to 90. At 1.2, let me have this on 0.1 snap first. At 1.2, we're going to go to 180. At 1.8, we are going to go to 270. And then at the very end, we're going to go to 359 just to get us to the very last degree of our rotation. So now when we play this, this is just going to be a looping rotation of our Godot icon. So with all that taken care of, let's actually go in and add a script for our loading screen. Get rid of all of this. Let's save this real quick. And before we write any of this, let's just go into our project settings. We're going to go to our globals. This is an existing one. Make sure you go and find your scene, our loading screen, and you're going to be doing a loading screen scene file as your auto load. So let's just make sure that you have that added to your project. Back in the script, we're going to have a signal for our scene loaded. We're going to have an onReady variable for our label and our timer. We're going to have a variable for our dot count, which is going to be an integer default to 0. We're going to have a scene path, which is a string. It will be an empty one for now. We're going to have a loading status, which is an int default to 0. We're going to have a scene ready to load bool, which can default to false. We're going to have a loaded scene variable, which is going to be of the type packed scene. And then we're going to have an artificial delay timer, which is a timer. So the artificial delay timer is going to be how we enforce a specific amount of time while we're reloading the scenes, which is not something that you're going to want, but just for demonstration purposes, we're going to use it. So let's set up just the bones of the methods right now. We're going to have our ready. We're going to have our process. We're going to have a start loading method, which takes in a path, which is a string. We're going to have our on dots timer timeout method. We're going to have an on scene loaded method. We're going to have an on artificial delay timer timeout method. And then lastly, we're going to have a change scene. Okay, so back up in ready, the first thing that we're going to do, we're going to hide it. And we're going to set process to false. Then we're going to tap into our timer, timeout, connect on our dots timer timeout. And then we're going to set up our artificial delay timer. I'm just going to copy and paste this code in, but all we're doing here is I need to fix the name here. And all we're doing here is creating our artificial timer in code. I'm going to bump this up to 4 seconds, actually, just so that means we're going to be seeing our loading screen for a total of 4 seconds before we reload our scene. In process, we're going to get the loading status. We're going to set it to our resource loader dot load threaded get status, and we pass in our scene path. Then we're going to do a match on this loading status, where the first one is resource loader dot thread load loaded. So this is a successful load. Then we do our on scene loaded. Otherwise, we do our resource loader, and then we do a thread load failed. And if we get that, all we're going to do is push an error up and said scene failed to load. In start loading, we set our scene path equal to the path we're passing in. We show. We set process to true. We get our timer and we start it. Then we do our label.text is going to equal to loading. And then we need to do some async loading. So we go back into the resource loader.load threaded request, and we pass in our scene path. And then we want to start our artificial delay timer. On the dots timer timeout, we're going to get our dots count, and it's going to be equal to the dots count plus 1 mod 4. We're going to get a variable called dots, which is going to be equal to an empty string. We match on our dots count, where if we are at 0, dots is an empty string. 1 dots is equal to 1 dot. 2 dots is equal to 2 dots. And 3, the dots is equal to 3 dots. Outside of this match, we get our label text, and it's going to be set equal to loading plus our dots. On the scene loaded, we do a loaded scene is equal to the resource loader dot load threaded get, pass in the scene path. Scene ready to load is now true. If we have an artificial delay timer with time left that's greater than 0, we're just going to return, so we don't do anything yet. Otherwise, we change scene. On the artificial delay timer timeout, if the scene is ready to load, change scene. Lastly, inside of change scene, the first thing we're going to do is stop our animations. So we set process to false. Then we go to our timer, we stop it. We go to our artificial delay timer, stop it. Then we need to handle our scene transition. So we're going to get a variable, call it current scene. It's going to be equal to get tree dot current scene. We're going to have a scene instance. It's going to be equal to our loaded scene and instantiate. Then we get tree root add child of our scene instance. Then we get tree dot current scene is going to be equal to our scene instance. We have to do a little bit of cleanup. So we do our current scene, we queue free, we hide, and then we need to reset some state. So we do our scene path, it's an empty string. Scene ready to load is false again. Loaded scene is now null. And then we emit our signal. And that wraps this up. In order to show this, we're going to go back to our example scene, and we're going to make a button that just handles this. So let's add a button here. We can call this our reload button. Just going to put the text of reload in it, drag it more in our scene, and then we go to our node, and then we want to on the button pressed, connect to that signal, and then we can tap in to our loading screen since we made this an on ready. We're going to do start loading and then scene file path. So now when we play this, when I press reload, we go into my screen here for 4 seconds and we reload this level, which obviously is not what you're really going to want for a loading screen, but just to show how this works, we're just going to use this reload button.